Last into the den is Marc Wileman, an entrepreneur who's turned his love of science into a business. But can he convince the dragons? He also understands the science of making money.
Hi, my name is Marc Wileman, or Mad Marc at times like this. And about 6.5 years ago, I founded a company called Sublime Science. And we make science awesome for primary school children all around the country. I'm here today for £50,000 investment for 10% equity in Sublime Science. Sublime Science started off with pretty humble beginnings, just me alone from the Prince's Trust and my parents' spare bedroom. But thankfully, the kids loved what we did. And now the Sublime Science Party is the most popular children's party in the UK, with 1,124 glowing reviews so far, last time we counted. It's also the winner of the NetMums Award for the best kids' party. And in addition to that, we've even received a congratulatory letter from Number 10 Downing Street. But it's not just science parties we do. We also make science fun for children in primary schools as well, with our Sublime Science workshops and stage shows that we do there. We've also worked with the British Science Association and the Museum of Childhood. There's also two books that I've published, both with fairly amusing titles. One is Don't Eat Your Slime. The second is The Most Incredible Science Experiment Book Ever. Both of which, though, have had great reviews from children all around the country and literally around the world who've used them to make science fun. So far, we've made science awesome for about 282,000 children. But I know we can do even more than that. So with your investment expertise today, I'd like to make science fun for 1 million children. Guessing you might have a few questions, but before we do that, it'd be really awesome if we could make some slime.
Not words you often hear spoken in the den.
Thank you so much.
Marc Wileman wants to stir the dragon's interest in a £50,000 investment to help grow his science parties for school kids. On offer in return is just a 10% stake in his company.
Hi, Marc. It almost feels like this is a real mission for you.
It's a real personal mission. Like, the Britain, the UK, England, we've got, like, probably the richest history of, like, incredible scientists. And just, you know, to have the opportunity to make science fun for children at that primary school age, yeah, it's just a privilege to be able to do it, really.
How long have you been doing this?
6.5 years.
And how many people have you got working for you with these parties?
We've got 3 full-time staff and 3 part-time staff, plus me. And then we've got 100 freelance presenters that we've trained through our training programme.
Last 12 months, what have you turned over as a business and what was the profit?
We turned over 533 and made a net profit of 177.
533,000?
Yes.
Wow. And 100 and how much profit?
77, 177.
177 net profit?
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Turnover for this year will be 750 with a profit of 250. Next year, we're going to turn over 1 million with a profit of 330.
I have to say, I'm incredibly impressed. I was expecting you not to give anything like those sort of numbers and results. I'm shocked.
The striking figures behind Marc's nutty professor act has instantly grabbed the attention of the class. The dragons may well want a slice for themselves. But Tuka Suleiman is wondering why he needs dragon capital at all.
Marc, science was definitely not my subject at school. But I admire what you've done. And in a way, when I look at the numbers, you don't need any investment. You've got a very good business, very profitable. I mean, in a way, it's a cash cow. If I had to ask you, how much cash have you got in the bank today?
Sure.
How much have you got?
Six figures.
Six figures?
Yeah.
Either I'm the mad scientist or you're the mad scientist, right?
Sure.
You've got plenty of money in the bank.
Sure.
Right?
Absolutely.
And you're here today looking for money.
I'm looking for investment.
I have no interest in science. I'm a fashion man.
Sure.
Production, branding. I really can't see what I can do for you. I have to say, I'm not going to invest so I'm out.
Tuukka Suliman's early withdrawal proves big numbers aren't always a route to success in the den. Marc still has plenty of work to do to convince the remaining dragons his business experiment is worth backing.
What's in the future that you feel that you need to bring somebody in to help you achieve that?
Yeah, from a distribution and marketing standpoint, I'd like to broaden how we get customers and try and really take this whole thing to the next level. And I think the potential is absolutely massive, both in the UK market and obviously globally. I have an idea of licensing the full concept from the book to the club to the products and taking that specifically, to the North American market, but also English-speaking countries. Obviously, you know, I've not licensed a business globally, you know, before. And I think that by bringing on the right investor, I'm not really sort of looking to give anything away. I'm looking to add to the business.
A clear vision of his company's future and an impressive turnover. Behind Marc's geeky exterior clearly lies a business brain. Has e-commerce mogul Nick Jenkins found a kindred spirit?
Marc, I think we probably share some very similar passions. I just think it's wonderful to really inspire kids to take an interest in science. So this is right up my street. And I think I can add something here. Definitely got a little bit of the experience with how to get it out there online. A more strategic vision of how you can make this big and how you can get this concept out to more people. So, you know, to be perfectly honest, I'm going to make you an offer. I'm going to give you all of the money for what you've suggested for 10% of the equity.
Thank you so much.
A direct offer and at the asking price. But is Nick Jenkins the only dragon who believes they can take Marc's business to new heights?
I love where you started from. You started because actually you wanted to do some good.
Yeah.
And not many people start from that and manage to create a really, really good business. And actually, I can see why you want to get a dragon on board now. And I totally see it's not about the money.
Sure.
It is about that next step. And I spent years and years and years doing international licensing and franchising. And I think you're right that that's a good path for you to go down. So I'm also going to make you an offer. I'd also like to offer you all of the money for 10% of the business.
Brilliant, I guess. Thank you so much.
Marc now has two matching offers to consider from dragons with expertise in different areas. Will leisure industry tycoon Deborah Meaden make it a hat trick?
Can I ask, have you done anything with the holiday and tourism market?
I've not managed to do a small fraction of everything I believe that we can do.
Well, a lot of these holiday businesses, they are crying out for something new. I can see that there'd be a whole piece there that you could build a program for them and sell it for them to,
yeah, absolutely,
to execute. And I think I can help you with that. I would very much want to be part of it. I think it's very exciting. I'm going to make you an offer. I'm going to offer you all of the money for 10%. And I'm sitting here excited, you know, thinking, please let it be me. because, you know, I can see what we should do here.
A rarely seen moment in the den. Marc now has three of the five dragons fighting to give him the cash he wants for the amount of equity he's willing to give up. Will Peter Jones, who likes to drive a hard bargain, follow suit and offer the same?
It is exceptional. And there are so many great opportunities with it. It's very exciting. One thing I was sitting at, I do a lot of work with the convenience stores. And amazingly, there's like 35,000 outlets. And I'm thinking, I've got that contract in the UK. I wonder if you could have and introduce your Mad Marc club at that convenience point, because it's all about distribution at that point, as you know, and it's those outlets. And I'm thinking, perhaps you could. And then I was thinking, actually, about the parties. I own Red Letter Days. What a great experience for a mum to go and buy a Red Letter Day experience, which is a Mad Marc party. So I'm really keen as well. But I don't want to accept the fact that they just want the 10%, because I want more. I'm going to chance my hand, and I'm going to make you an offer. I'm going to offer you all of the money, but I'm going to ask for 20% of the business.
Peter Jones brings the number of offers up to 4, but in a bold move, he's gambled on his contacts being worth more of the company than Marc is prepared to give away. And now, Nick Jenkins is ready to make things even more interesting.
Can I raise the ante a little bit? I'm going to suggest to Sarah that maybe if you got 2 dragons to split this, you get 2 dragons coming in on this with 2 sets of creativity. Sarah, how would you feel about that?
I'd love to split it with you, Nick. I really would like to be part of this.
I think that's an even better offer.
In a bid to outflank the more established members of the Den, Sarah Willingham and Nick Jenkins have rolled the dice with a joint offer for 10% of Marc's company. Will he think 2 dragons are better than 1, though?
Right, I'm just going to go have a chat with that wall back there. Cheers.
What a great business.
Marc now needs to weigh up which dragon's experience he most values and whether Peter Jones is worth 10% more equity.
Nick and Sarah, I'd like to accept your offer.
Oh, amazing.
Thank you. Well done. Appreciate it.
Brilliant.
Well done.
That's awesome news.
That's really
Thank
exciting.
So
We're going to do ace things.
Thank you so much.
Finally, a successful conclusion. As shrewd scientist Marc Wileman hits on a winning formula for his business by combining 2 separate elements in the Den.
Well done, Nick.
Yeah.
Well done, guys.
I thought that was the best way to compete.
It was awesome. I just looked at them fighting to get involved in the business as a massive compliment. I chose to take Nick and Sarah's investment, really because I just felt that connection and enthusiasm and passion was there. Hopefully everything will work out pretty well.